Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to be talking about lists in Python. What are they? What are they good for? And how do we implement one in our Python code? In Python, lists are a type of data that is an efficient way of storing larger amounts of data. Typically, we want the information to be related some way as well, otherwise it could get very confusing. So, if we wanted to create a website and we wanted to attribute each user of our website as a list, we could combine all that user's information into one consolidated list. The best thing about lists is that we can store any data type within the list that we want to. So it could be a string, a boolean, an integer, etc. Now that we have an idea of what lists are in Python, how do we go about implementing and recalling one? To implement a list in Python, we initiate it the same way we would a variable. So let's call it YouTube channel. Then we put an equals, square brackets, and then we insert our pieces of data with a comma separating each piece of data. So let's say I want my name, then my subscribers, and then my total channel views. So, since my name is a string, I must use quotation marks, and then the last two pieces of information are just integers, so quotation marks are not needed. Then, we need to end the list by using another square bracket. Now, let's verify what I just stated. In that, Python has no problems with users entering different types of information into a single list. Therefore, let's print the first two pieces of information and check their data type. Firstly, I just want to add that the position a piece of data has in a list is called its index. And in Python, these always start with 0 and not 1. So if I want to recall the name, let's print the name of our list, square brackets again, and a 0 since we want the first item in the list. And we'll also add an extra line to check the type of the data. Now let's repeat what we just did for the number of subscribers. Once running the code, we can see that everything was returned properly and as expected. Another interesting thing to note is that if you want to print all pieces of data after a certain index, you can just add a colon after the index position. There are also ways to alter your list using list functions, however, this will be further introduced in the next video. Also, if you wanted to, you could just print the whole list by stating print and then the list name. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.